SCI Pittsburgh, will you be working with the local authorities, meaning the mayor, county exec, as well as Representative Wheatley? I know that's his district. Will you be working with them to talk about what will happen to the SCI Pittsburgh facilities? And secondly, I have a couple questions. I know you've been a major component on helping to eliminate blight. Can you talk about how blight has hindered local communities as well as throughout this Commonwealth? And can you tell me the importance of, because I know you served in this position, of redevelopment authorities and their ability to remove blight from local communities? As well as, can you talk about from an MBEWB standpoint, particularly when it comes to African-American business, from last year to this year, how much have we increased the state's contracts with minority business?
Thank you, Representative. Those are all great questions. First of all, the State Correctional Institute of Pittsburgh, we're working very closely with them. To that end, Deputy Secretary Dunkelberger and I have a meeting, I think it's next Friday, with the mayor, the county executive, Senator Fontana, Representative Wheatley, to talk about next steps. We've been working very closely with the Department of General Services and Secretary Topper regarding that, and we think that they're doing a great job of trying to move the process along, but in a very sensitive way, since there are going to be a number of people that are going to be relocated in terms of their jobs and also the inmates at the facility. But we want to be able to be ready to transfer the property for the appropriate use, and there are a lot of good ideas on what that appropriate use would be. But our point of going next week is to talk directly with the local elected officials to talk about the timing and next steps and when we can do or what we can do with that. With respect to blight, that is one of the critical issues that we're seeing around. Not only from my background, but from around the state. Blight is, one of the things that we'll talk about a little bit more, because I'm sure it'll come up, is the ability to market Pennsylvania in a much better way, and the ability to attract people, and especially young people, into communities within Pennsylvania. And blight gets in the way, and opportunities, and we need to be proactive about that, and working with communities to do that. Working with the federal government and the Community Development Block Grant Program, the HOME Program, and a variety of others, we get probably $75 to $80 million per year under those programs to distribute to communities, specifically to eradicate blight. It is absolutely critical. We need to keep doing that and be aggressive about that. In terms of redevelopment authorities, I ran a redevelopment authority. Absolutely critical for redevelopment authorities to continue to do what they need to do. In particular, with some of the things that are happening in Pennsylvania, we have an abundance of low-cost energy in shale gas that can be utilized for a variety of different companies and businesses, not only that want to expand in Pennsylvania, but that want to come to Pennsylvania. And these redevelopment authorities are critical, and there are kind of our boots on the ground for us to be able to fund and help them to prepare sites for development, and what they do is very important. And in terms of the our diversity initiatives, and I think I give a lot of credit to Deputy Secretary Kilko for some of the things that we've done in our department to really advance our diversity initiatives. We started a diversity committee last year within our department, and to look at a variety of ways to include diversity in our program development, in keeping with the governor's executive order, and then also looking at diversity within our department, and promoting that. And one of the things that you'll probably see over the course of the next couple of months is us tweaking some of the programs, existing programs that we have right now, to be able to utilize those programs for minority women, veteran, diverse businesses and opportunities. So we're really trying to put a lot of attention to that, and aggressively. Thank you.
Do we have any data that suggests here's where we were last year and here's where we are this year in terms of the percentage of contracts that's going to minority businesses?
We do. I think for our department, we probably have that information. If we do, I'll certainly get that to the chairman.
I appreciate it. Thank you. Yes. And again, yes. Thank you, Dennis.